Welcome to Vintage Reviews. I am George, and today we are going to talk about the film... Day of the Triffids was originally released in 1963. It starred Howard Keel, Nicole Mori, Janet Scott, and Kieran Moore. It was directed by Steve Seckley, with a little bit of help from Freddie Francis, and we'll talk a little bit more about that as we go along. So let's talk about the plot. It is a very cool end-of-the-world type story. It starts out in London, and there is this meteor shower going on. And it is brilliant. It is beautiful. There's lots of colorful lights, and it draws everybody's attention to it. Well, what ends up happening is anyone who looked at this meteor shower ends up going blind. 99% of the population watched this meteor shower because it was so cool looking, and so 99% of the population is no longer able to see. And that's a pretty cool end-of-the-world device that you don't really see very often, and it is quite terrifying if you think about it. And then if that's not bad enough, the world ends up getting overrun by these giant murderous plant monsters known as Triffids. And a Triffid can walk. It can uproot and walk around and sting you with these stingers and kill you. So that's what we have. We have everyone is blind, and there are murderous plant monsters running around killing people. So our main character is a guy named Bill Mason, and he is played by Howard Keel. Now, Howard Keel was mostly known for musicals, things like Seven Brides for Seven Brothers and Calamity Jane. But in this movie, he gets to play the hero guy. He is a naval officer, apparently stationed in England. And at the beginning of the film, he is having eye surgery, so his eyes are wrapped up and he doesn't see the meteor shower. And he wakes up the next day and he takes off the bandages and he can see, but suddenly he's thrust into this world gone mad. And he has to figure out his way through it and find some kind of sanctuary. So along the way, he's seeing trains wrecking. He's seeing people walking around like blind zombies bumping into each other. He's seeing cars wrecked. There's planes crashing. And it's actually a pretty terrifying world that he ends up seeing. And that's pretty compelling stuff for this kind of film, I think. Then there is this subplot going on. And this involves a guy named Tom Goodwin and his wife Karen, and they are scientists, and they happen to be living in this lighthouse off the coast in its secluded place, and they don't watch the meteor shower either. They're too busy griping at each other and doing science stuff, and they don't watch the meteor shower, so they don't go blind. And so what they end up doing is they do experiments on the Triffids. They end up killing one. And they do experiments on it, and they're trying to figure out what makes the Triffids tick. So that's basically the plot of the film. Actually, pretty good stuff, I think. So there are a couple of trivia things I'd like to talk about. First of all, the characters played by Kieran Moore and Janet Scott, the Goodwins, the interesting thing about them is they weren't part of the original film. They were added later, because when they filmed the movie, they found out that they only had 57 minutes of usable footage. So that was the part with Howard Keel playing the Bill Mason going around surviving. When they finished all that, they only had 57 minutes, and that wasn't long enough for a movie. So they had to go in and they had to put the subplot in with the Goodwins in the lighthouse doing experiments on Triffids. And that was directed by Freddie Francis. Kind of go back on what I said earlier about the director. So he's not credited, but he actually shot that whole thing, which is about a half an hour of the movie. Now this film is based on a book by John Wyndham. And in the original novel, the Triffids were experimental plants that were capable of moving around on their own. But in the film version, they decided to change them into aliens. So that's a little bit different, but it actually worked out fine, I think. Now to say a little bit about the Triffid designs. They're about as good as you can get with a squishy plant walking around going, I mean, that's all it is. They're not the greatest looking monsters in the world, but when they get a bunch of them together, that is pretty scary. I mean, they're a force of nature in a way. They don't really think. They're just out to attack you. And, you know, you can shoot them, but they don't go down from that. I mean, you have to do things like burn them or run from them. And if there's a whole bunch of them coming at you, you're kind of in trouble. So they make for a compelling enemy, even though the look of them are, you know, a little bit hokey. So what are my overall impressions of the film? I actually quite enjoy it. It's well-paced. It's 90 minutes long, and there's not a lot of filler in there. There's always something kind of going on. The characters are moving, and they go from one crisis to the next, and they move and they move. And there's nothing slow about it. It's not boring. It has a good pace, and I like that a lot. Now, is it cheesy? Yes, it's cheesy, but cheesy in a good way. Let's think of the genre of sci-fi film as a plate of nacho chips. This film is the cheese whiz. You pour over the nacho chips, and then you take a chip, and it's dripping with cheese, and you bite into it, and you crunch down on the gooey goodness. That's what this is. It's just cheesy, gooey, good filmmaking. So again, the film is Day of the Triffids from 1963. Lots of good campy stuff. I appreciate you taking the time to tune in to my video. I hope you enjoyed it. And until the next time, have a good one.